win in Brock Lesnar. Welcome to Heat, everybody. Alongside D'Lo Brown, I am the coach.
What up, coach?
Oh, baby, so much to talk about right here on Heat.
Rolling contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first from Hollywood, California, weighing 260 pounds.
We have a brand new WWE champion. But coach, what we got shocked and surprised us all completely.
What you're talking about is the fact that Brock Lesnar has now decided to go to SmackDown exclusively. But he was not the only one. The Undertaker as well. And D'Lo, we'll talk about it and show everybody right here on Heat.
Man, I'm telling you, the WWE Raw is on its ear. Man, oh, I got to see the footage now, coach.
No, we got to wait. We got to wait. A little bit later. Relax, kid.
Weighing 248 pounds, Johnny Stamboli.
Yo, Johnny Stamboli was walking through the neighborhood the other day, and this guy named Tony Scraccione came up to me and he said, "Hey, Johnny, what's the key to a successful marriage?" I sat, I thought about it for a second, and then bada boom, it hit me. The key to a successful marriage is never introduce your wife to Johnny Stamboli.
Whoa.
What?
What is he thinking? A player?
From the Himalaya hands?
Oh, Lord.
He's not. You know, I'm still wondering if Johnny Stamboli was even awake when he was talking right there.
He sounded like Mushmouth. He was mumbling.
Exactly.
He may not be the best of marriage advice, but he's definitely learning what to do inside the ring right here. You can see he's taking advantage of Goldust.
He does get better week to week. And right now, Stamboli taking the early advantage here against Goldust. And we talk about Goldust, D'Lo. Goldust and Booker T last Sunday at SummerSlam coming within an eyelash of becoming the new tag team champion.
In a heartbeat of taking the belt. Within a heartbeat, as I was saying, of taking the belts from around the waist of the Un-Americans and bringing it back to Booker T and Goldust. You know what? I think it's only a matter of time before these two track down the Un-Americans again.
I hope so. I'm getting sick and tired of Landstorm, Christian, and Tess. We'll talk more about Tess a little bit later. We'll have Goldust setting up for the curtain call. But Stamboli says, that ain't going to happen. I mean, when you talk about SummerSlam and what a great night it was, certainly the great fans. And
Oh, no.
Man,
your body's not supposed to bend like that. He dropped him on his back, his side.
Wow. Goldust on the top rope, and now Stamboli taking advantage. Last week at SummerSlam, the crowd was off the charts in Nassau Coliseum, and they got to see a Shawn Michaels that you couldn't tell you he hadn't been in the ring for over 4.5 years.
You know, it had been 4.5 years, like you said, since HBK was in the ring. To me, it seemed more like 4.5 minutes.
Yeah.
He didn't miss a beat. The Showstopper was out there. The Heartbreak Kid was out there. It looked like the Shawn Michaels.
Wait a second. Here's a cover. Hook of the leg, two, and a kick out by Goldust. Yeah. Unfortunately, D'Lo, Triple H did what he said he was going to do. Despite losing the match, taking that sledgehammer to the back of Shawn Michaels, severe back trauma by the Heartbreak Kid, and we don't know even tonight what the status of Shawn Michaels is at this point.
Not one sledgehammer, but two shots to the back, the already injured back. And I'm just, my heart prayers go out to Shawn Michaels, hopefully a speedy and quick recovery.
I don't know when we're going to see Shawn Michaels again, but if that's the last time we see Shawn Michaels in the ring, what a finale for the Heartbreak Kid. Tremendous, tremendous effort last Sunday night. Oh, and now Stamboli, you talk about a tremendous effort, just taking it to Goldust.
Stamboli's kicking it up a whole nother notch.
Here's another cover, hook of the leg, two, and getting the shoulder up is Goldust.
He's raising up a whole nother gear. What a tremendous upset this would be for Stamboli. You know, and it's only his, you know, fourth or fifth appearance on Heat to get a win on Goldust. Man, what a catapult that would be for his career.
Yeah, we've seen him 4, 5, maybe 6 times, and he's already getting underneath my skin.
Oh,
this
yeah.
whole cocky, you know, New York type of accent. You know, I'm sure at some point he's successful with the ladies, but not like what he was talking about earlier. Please.
You know, those who talk about it so much don't usually get anything at all. You know how it works.
Well, some people. But
except
you know me.
For you, Coach.
I talk about it a lot. Everybody knows my track record. Well, now Stamboli looking to wear out Goldust, trying to cut off some of the air to Goldust's head.
But you see, Goldust is trying to, he's trying to get the blood flowing again. He's trying to get the people behind him, get that extra boost of just a little something. He's trying to reach down deep just to bring something out you know, it's kind of working here.
Well, here we go. Goldust expending a lot of energy, trying to get back to his feet. Now straight back into the corner. And Stamboli capitalizes again.
Just as quick as Goldust came up, Stamboli just knocked him right back down.
Well, now rolls him over. Here's a cover. Very lackluster. However, not going to hit Goldust like that.
See, that's where he slipped. That's where he's a young rookie. He doesn't hook. He didn't hook the leg. He didn't put him in tight to make the kick out even more difficult. That was a very easy kick out for Goldust to make.
You know, when you talk about SummerSlam as well, we've got to talk about the fact that the Intercontinental title is back now. It's back on Raw thanks to that huge victory. Oh, he's going to roll by Goldust. 1-2 on a kick out by Stamboli. But Eric Bischoff very pleased that the Intercontinental title is back on Raw thanks to Rob Van Dam.
Well, the Intercontinental title is back where it belongs, back on Raw. And, you know, I just wish somehow we get the Undisputed title back where it belongs, too.
Yeah, that's not going to happen. Stephanie paid a lot of money to Brock Lesnar and Paul Heyman. And, you know, you can't blame the next big thing, I guess, for going after the money.
You got to take the greenbacks. You got to go.
You certainly do. Now, Foles been attempting to get back to their feet. And you can hear this crowd urging Goldust on. And now both men going toe-to-toe.
Toe-to-toe, coach. Toe-to-toe.
And now Stamboli off the rope. Oh, right into a huge clothesline.
A bevy of clotheslines by Goldust here. And dare I say he's about to make the classic comeback.
Oh, where the sun don't even think about coming. And another clothesline. Quick as a cat is Goldust 1-2. But Stamboli able to kick out. You would think that maybe he'd see one of those clotheslines coming.
You know, give him a light, because, you know, a compass or something, because brother's lost out there right now.
Oh, what out Goldust down to his back and a big shot to that kisser of Johnny Stamboli.
Uh-oh.
Oh, and now setting up Stamboli.
This could be.
If he nails it, it is the curtain call. The curtain call, and as Stamboli would say,
forget about it. Miserable punk, and he got out by grilling. You know, right there, he got dealt with. You know, he said he was in personal playground, so I can let him know that D'Lo Brown ain't the one to mess with.
And he almost nailed me that.
You know, punk, you got out by grill too.
Yeah, well, things didn't end there because the next week, Raven came out and pushed the face to you, and instead brought out Stamboli, nailed you with the crutch, and Stamboli picks up the win.
And, you know, and here it is, you know, I'm just incredible. Scoring the sky high, get the 1-2-3. I'm celebrating with all the D'Lo Nation out there, and out from behind, from nowhere, boot DDT Raven effect.
Yeah, what a shock, Raven attacking you from behind, but it all comes to a head right here tonight, because D'Lo, you go one-on-one with Raven.
Coach, I can't wait to get his poke ass in the ring.
I can't wait either, but coming up next, it's Steven Richards and Crash. We're coming right back. We're back on Heat and D, and sure is great to have the big red machine came back, dare I say, in the hang.
The red one is back, and he's back on Raw.
He's scheduled for one ball. Introducing first from Wallingford, Connecticut, weighing 230 pounds, Steven Richards.
Hey, Coach, where is Wallingford, Connecticut at?
Where is Steven Richards' mind at?
I think Wallingford is in his mind. I don't think that place exists.
I think it actually does. Unlike Planastasiak, which does not exist.
From Mobile, Alabama, weighing 220 pounds, Crash.
Well, here comes Crash, who a couple of weeks ago decided to fill in for you, D, when you were taking a hiatus. I think you were vacationing somewhere down in the Bahamas or something.
No, Coach, I was doing my night job. I had to go perform inside the ropes instead of up here on the stage.
I forgot about that.
You know that other job.
I forgot about that. My bad. Wait a second. The Helsinki judge just gave him a 9-9.
I just got the facts on my pager. My page. The Helsinki judge gave him a perfect 10 on that lightning.
He's been the toughest judge today.
Perfect 10.
The toughest judge today. But here we go. Steven Richards and Crash should be a very entertaining matchup here on Heat. But speaking of entertaining matchups, how about last Sunday at SummerSlam? Ric Flair and Chris Jericho and the Nature Boy teaching Y2J a little lesson.
You know, the Nature Boy has always said for years he's the dirtiest player in the game. He's also called himself Space Mountain. And I think he said that it may be the oldest ride in the park, but still has the longest line.
Wait a second, a little ha-ha by Crash, and Steven Richards buys into it, and right there, a huge clothesline, followed up by a nice drop kick.
You know, Ric Flair has forgotten more about wrestling than Y2J will ever learn.
Yeah, let's not take too much away from Chris Jericho, because he is a tremendous superstar in his own right. However, disrespecting the Nature Boy like that just can't happen. And then to come out on Raw and show everybody that Ric Flair actually tapped. Well, Ric Flair was grabbing onto the rope when he tapped. Everybody knows he didn't tap.
Yeah, he held the rope and then he tapped. That doesn't count. Oh. He had to break the hold.
And what about the rendition of New York, New York at Madison Square Garden for over 5 minutes? Oh, you know, the crowd was just chanting, get out of the ring. You know,
the Bronx cheers were out. The Boo Birds were in the house with his rendition of New York, New York, trying to compare himself to the great Frank Sinatra.
Yeah, YJ thinks he's a good singer. I don't know who told him that, but he thinks he is.
I think the person that stole the money for singing lessons told him he's a great singer.
Oh, wow. Steven Richards, a huge slap on Crash. You can hear that one all the way up in the rafters.
That was a huge knife-edge chop. Did you just hear that?
And now Steven Richards and Crash going toe-to-toe.
Again.
You know, there's another matchup that had epic proportions, that had the anticipation of the crowd on Monday night on the edge of their seats all night long. You know which match I'm talking about.
Well, you know, it was the number one contenders match, Coach.
No. I'm talking about Howard Finkel and Lillian
Garcia. No. Come on.
I am. I'm not kidding.
Come on, Coach.
Oh, what a tremendous evening gown and tuxedo match that, quite frankly, I hope I never see again.
Well, you know, Coach, I'm still having nightmares from that because when Howard was stripped down, it looked like a raw Christmas turkey out there.
You said a raw Christmas turkey.
A raw Christmas turkey.
Oh, that's scary.
I couldn't shut my eyes. I kept thinking about that vision of Howard Finkel rolling around the mat almost naked.
Oh, wait a second. Steven Richards now going to
the high rental stick.
Oh, well, what a shot. Playing to the crowd, wasting way too much time, and Crash takes advantage. You know, real quick, I think in Howard's dreams when he had Stacy Keibler, Trish Stratus, and Lillian undressing him, it didn't end like that.
It didn't happen
in front of 18,000. Yeah.
And the millions and millions watching at home.
Oh, and now Crash taking control. A big forearm to the head of Steven Richards.
Crash getting all fired up, making that comeback.
Well, here he's talking about Stacy, Trish, and Lillian. Backdrop by Crash. And now he is all fired up.
He's all fired up. Like I said earlier, somebody's making a classic comeback, and looks like Crash is the one doing it right now.
Well, you can see that. Maybe that rib cage is hurting Crash a little bit.
Oh, you can definitely see that. It's definitely slowing him down. It's impairing his movements.
And nevertheless, Crash is going up top.
Why would he go up there if he's hurting that much? I mean, it must be just adrenaline or emotion.
I get. Oh, nice elevation. Nice drop kick. And you can see it is affecting him. Will he be able to get over for the cover? A weak cover. 1-2. And Steven Richards able to get the foot on the rope.
You see, those ribs are hurting him. He could not get over properly and make the correct cover and hook the other leg. That's allowed Steven Richards to put his foot up on the rope to break the count.
Now both men have certainly given it everything they have and then some. And now Crash going up top. Oh, but Steven Richards able to get out of the way. Oh, going for a clothesline. Away.
Oh, my goodness.
Wow, the Steven kick out of nowhere.
Wacko just went crazy there. Got the 1-2-3.
Here is your winner. Steven Richards!
Steven Richards and Crash know each other very, very well.
Let's show him!
And Steven Richards did show him tonight, picking up the win. But folks, still to come tonight, Raven gets his.
That's right, Coach. I've been dreaming about this match for weeks.
Oh, it's finally going to happen tonight. And speaking of dreaming, being next is Bradshaw and Just Incredible. Plenty more heat on the other side. You know, D, it was supposed to be a special night for Jimmy Superfly Snuka. He thought Bischoff brought him for all to give him a lifetime achievement award, but that's not exactly what happened.
That was brutal, very brutal with Bischoff did him. I cannot believe how he swore this
in the game. The contest is scheduled for Woodfall. Introducing first from Sweetwater, Texas, weighing 292 pounds, Bradshaw.
Was Bradshaw gets ready to roll here on Heat. I can tell you that Heat is brought to you tonight by MGM's Barbershop. Great new movie starring Ice Cube, and it's rated PG-13.
And by the new Castro GTX High Mileage.
I give you the hard one. And by JVC's Tower of Power with 460 watts of mind-numbing sound, dual 8-inch subs, and MP3 playback. the Tower of Power by JBC.
Stealing Brock Lesnar way over to SmackDown.
Yeah, Stephanie pulling out the checkbook to bring over the Undisputed Champion. I guess you can't fault Brock Lesnar for chasing the money. And folks, we're going to show you that entire story, the huge main event, the number one contenders match from Raw involving Triple H and The Undertaker. And there's more to this story than just Brock Lesnar.
Without a doubt, there's a whole backstory. And man, we still know everything that's going on. We still know the backdoor deals and everything that's happening. I know Bradshaw knows what's happening there. He just knocked the snot out of Justin.
Well, Bradshaw's always ready. And with Bradshaw, the shorter the match, the better. The only way that Justin Credible has a chance here tonight is if he can draw this match out. Get the big Texan tire.
Yeah, wear the big Texan out. Let this match, if this match goes more than 3 or 4 or 5 minutes, it then weighs into the favor of Justin Credible because he's smaller, lighter, has less bulk to pull around. I was about to say quicker, but yeah. He kind of got caught off guard.
Bradshaw's kind of quick for his size. This guy is, 6'7".
Oh, my goodness.
About 290, 300 pounds of just sheer brute, what I like to call back home, country toughness.
And he's got country strength, too.
Oh, my goodness. This guy is mean, and it's never pretty. It's never a ballet, if you will, when you're in the ring with Bradshaw.
Bradshaw does nothing pretty, but he's effective, and he gets the job done.
Nice neck breaker by Justin Credible, and at least right now, Justin Credible is holding his own.
Well, yeah, he's holding his own, but, once again, he can't let the big Texan wear on him. And, see, here's the strength of Bradshaw reversing everything. And here's the strength of Bradshaw.
And you can see Credible's face going, no, no, no. Sack of potatoes, thanks for coming. And Bradshaw, I know you can't see it right now, but he's got the smile on his face that he always gets when he dishes out punishment.
He's always smiling because he knows he's like hurting people and he likes it.
He loves it. And now going for, and reverse, nice back bridge.
And Bradshaw didn't let go. Look at this.
Just like that, Bradshaw back to his feet. It appeared like Justin Credible had the advantage, at least for a moment.
And Justin is holding on to Bradshaw's leg for dear life, just begging not to go up.
And Bradshaw almost disdained, like he's ticked off that he was holding on to his left leg.
He's mad that he couldn't just pummel him more.
At least for a second, Justin Credible was playing the role of mini dust. But just for a second.
Just for a second.
And now Justin Credible off the ropes.
See, now that's great strategy. Take the big man down. If you can't go head-to-head with him, break him down, chop him down, bring him down a level. You alleviate all his strength, all his size if he's laying down the mat.
However, Justin Credible playing to the crowd, that could prove to be a mistake. But you got to get this big Texan off his feet, and he's going after that bad knee that Bradshaw has.
The heavily bandaged and braced up knee. That could be the one weakness of Bradshaw, is that knee.
Folks, don't forget, still to come a little bit later right here on Heat. Patna, I know you're getting excited. You need your chance at Raven, but wait a second, a huge super kick. This could be a huge upset, but getting the shoulder up is Bradshaw.
Well, Coach, tonight's a very, very special night.
Why's that?
I'm having an induction ceremony.
For what?
I'm inducting Raven into the Sky High Hall of Fame.
I can't wait for that.
Right here. My goodness. Where did that come from?
Tomorrow on Raw. And speaking of raising hell.
Oh yeah, Coach, it's just about time.
D'Lo and Raven, next. Welcome back to Heat, everybody. You know that music, whether you like it or not. D'Lo, it's just about time. I know you've been waiting a long time for this. He can't dodge you anymore.
Coach, I've been waiting all hour for this one. And brother's gonna get dealt with right now.
right, partner, why don't I take that headset for you right about now?
I tell you what, partner, here I go.
All right, then. Well, here we go. I think this crowd has been anticipating this one all night as well. And these two guys, to be quite frank with you, do not like each other. They never have. They never will. And you know how I feel about Raven, so we don't even need to go there. Well, now Raven taking the early offensive on D'Lo Brown. And I don't know if D'Lo's excitement may hurt him or help him here early on. But Raven apparently doesn't want any part of D'Lo here early on. Oh, now D'Lo. Nice drop kick to the kiss from Raven, and now sizing things up, up over and down onto Raven. And D'Lo may have had the wind knocked out of him. Well, folks, we saw a few moments ago what went down on Raw between Triple H, The Undertaker, and Brock Lesnar. And we are going to be live tomorrow night in Milwaukee. Oh, wow. And D'Lo is ready. We're going to be live tomorrow night in Milwaukee. You got to believe that Triple H and Eric Bischoff will not be pleased on D'Lo hard into the ring post on that left shoulder. And now Raven right back on top of D'Lo and right back to the ring post again. And D'Lo down on the outside. Raven, at least right now, able to catch his breath for a moment. This matchup started off at a fever pitch. And you can see both men. You know, it's a funny thing when you have two men that are going up against one another that don't like each other. How much they can bring out of each other and themselves. And that's what we're seeing right here tonight. And now Raven. One thing you cannot call Raven is stupid in the ring. This man is a seasoned veteran. He knows that once you get a weak spot on an opponent, you continue to take care of that. Oh, and a big knee lift by Raven to D'Lo. Here's a cover. Hook of the leg, 1-2, and a kick out. And Raven wasting no time, right back up on top of D'Lo. What a tremendous main event here on Heat. Oh, and now down hard on that left shoulder. Another cover, 1-2, but D'Lo kicks out once again. And now D'Lo, you can see, grabbing that left shoulder. It's taken a lot of punishment here throughout this matchup. And now ducking. Oh, and D'Lo, maybe not the smartest move, giving the clothesline with that injured left arm. And Raven goes right back towards that left arm and shoulder again. Folks, so much to get to this week on Raw and on SmackDown. What's going to happen as the Battle of the GMs rolls on? The fall is starting, but things continue to heat up as we head towards the final 4 months, really, in the year 2002. You talk about turning a page. We've turned a page big time here in the WWE. Now Raven going for the Raven Effect, but D'Lo able to catch that top rope and save himself from a sure Raven Effect. Oh, but nobody home. D'Lo going for the high-risk maneuver, going for that big elbow, but Raven quickly on top of D'Lo. 1-2, and another kick out. Wow, these two guys have been going so quick, so fast throughout this matchup. And now D'Lo into the corner. Oh, and Raven going for the patented clothesline. D'Lo ducks away, catches Raven, but unable to follow that up because of all the punishment that D'Lo has taken to this point. And now, both men attempting, desperately trying to get to their feet. As referee Chad Patton continues the count, now at 5, now at 6, and Raven the first to get back to his feet. Well, you heard D'Lo a few moments ago saying he was going to induct Raven into the Sky High Hall of Fame. I, for one, certainly hope that that does happen. Followed up by a big clothesline. You can hear D'Lo. Just get it up. Uh-oh. Yeah, give me some love. Give me some love. It's a second leg drop out onto Raven. Will this be enough? Hook of the leg. 1-2-0, and Raven somehow is able to kick out, and D'Lo flat out can't believe it. and an oh. But his disbelief quickly turned into a wriggly hive. And now, oh, D'Lo's got him up for the side effect. The side effect on Raven. This should be enough. Oh! But I gotta say, D'Lo is always talking about good covers. That, for my partner, was not a good cover. But D'Lo right back up, and you can see the determination on his face. And now Raven into the corner. Uh-oh. D'Lo continues to pummel Raven. And Raven goes down. Hey, D'Lo, pick him up and give him one more. Wouldn't offend me any. Oh, oh, no! Oh, no, Raven nails 1-2 on the foes on the ropes. But D'Lo, just before the count of three, is able to kick out. I thought certainly that Raven was going to be able to pick up the victory despite cheating with his feet on the ropes. And now Raven, and oh, D'Lo telegraphing that one. And Raven now going for the Raven effect right in the middle of the ring. But D'Lo reversals. Shot!